Hello, all who is watching us on YouTube channel. Today we say hello to you from Panevėžys Bitė Library, and we have special guests, which I will introduce just in a minute. I will say that we are talking on occasion that library has a unique project which involves three libraries of Lithuania. It's Panevėžys, Kaunas and Klaipėda County Libraries. Together with our partners from Norway, it's game design studio Black Book. And this project, first of all, seeks to create unique reading encouraging game for our teenagers. And this game creation process now, it's creative part is already finished. So we will talk about the game creative process with our partners and about reading and gaming situation in Norway as well. So now I would like to say hello to our partners from game design studio Black Book. This is Thomas,
hello.
Lynn, and Benedikte. And these people are very important for us because they did game design work in our project. But first of all, I will give question for you about more common question. Do you have projects in Norway which connect reading and gaming?
Yeah, I would say like when I grew up, I had like reading games that were like Josephine and those. Those were kind of like they did learn a bit of everything, but also reading. But I would say like generally, like projects like this is not really that more normal, more like smaller ones maybe, I would say.
Yeah, and parts and games can contain tasks about reading.
There can be quite a few like children's games based on learning to read and like the alphabets, but there's very few that encourage kids to learn for fun or to learn to read fiction, for example. That's very, very little.
Yeah, I would say there are like, yeah, there are games that would like learn you the alphabet,
yes,
but they're
yes.
not really like that
for
much.
For kindergarten children.
Yeah. There have been done some experiments now with putting those sort of games into schools because some of them have been proven really well to learn children how to read. But yeah, those that are more encouraging like teens and children to read, they don't really exist that much. It's more, yeah, it's more like learning the alphabet that they're kind of mainly focusing on. Yeah.
Well, this time we create a game for teenagers, for children, or even not even children, but for young people from 10 to 15 years, it's teenagers. It's not just alphabet you know, learners, but it's already people with very serious thinking and serious, let's say, experience in lives. And how did you find this process of creating game design for this audience?
I think what we first did was kind of like thinking about ourselves when we were like teens, like what problems we really had and struggles and interests that we really had. And then like we created a really character-based game. So for us it was really important to put these problems and like interests into these characters, because I think like at once you have characters that you can like feel the similarity to then you also will create something that's interesting. You create a connection and then you make something interesting. And yeah, that was also what we did with the reading game, was like trying to create a connection with characters that are really interested in books as well, that way.
I think we thought about the question, what's important when you're in that age, like friendship is quite important, trying to figure out of your own personality and stuff. So we thought about that.
Yeah.
And I think we went from there and did some brainstorming about several things, like important words, and then worked out from that again. and that's how we ended up with friends, a friend game.
And also you found very, I would say, interesting way how to integrate reading promotion into game, because one of our tasks was to create game which would stimulate reading, which would stimulate wish to read for these young people. So how did you find the way how to implement this reading promotion element into mobile game?
I think one thing for us that was very important is that it doesn't sound like an advert, right? We don't want to be like, hey, look at this, right? So we very early on decided to have the characters in the game to be interested in books themselves, because I think one of the easiest like sales methods now in this these years is word of mouth. If you tell me you read a really good book, I would be more interested than if I just saw an advert. So for us to like encourage children and teens to read, we wanted to have characters that are already interested in reading. So by having the characters in the game interested in books and interested in reading and wanting to talk about it, then it would hopefully carry on to the player as well.
Like you will listen to your friends, like what they are interested in, and take their suggestions. So when you hear it from friends like, oh, this helped me out, then yeah, that could like trigger some interest to actually test it out yourself.
And also the other very important task for this creative process was to implement somehow implement stimulation of good social relations. So it was really complicated task. How you solved this task we gave to you?
Yeah, I think we can go a bit back to that. We spoke about like how we really were as teens. And when you are a teen, you don't really talk about your struggles at all, because you're kind of like in a bit like an awkward zone where you're like, you don't really want to talk about your parents about things. You kind of want more to reach out a bit. So yeah, we wanted to have trying to create this friendly connection with the characters in the game that has their struggles. And as you, you know, create the connection to them, then they talk more about their struggles. And then you can maybe go and think a bit more about like, maybe I should talk more about like what my issues are, or maybe what I actually got some issues that I need to talk about, or maybe think more about, or maybe find a solution to. So yeah, we thought more of the characters as someone that would be a friend that would maybe like, yeah, like listen to you somehow, but in a way that they're kind of telling more about their struggles, and then you kind of get the realization.
In creative process, because on the one side there was three Lithuanian big libraries with big teams, on the other hand was Norway, your Black Book game design company, and how you could describe this process of creation wasn't very complicated for you, and how do you treat this experience working with Lithuanian library teams?
I think like for us it was like really interesting, like working. It's a bit different because when we have client work, you know, you get like a request for something, like they order something from us and then you make something. And it's kind of like the same, like we had some keywords that we worked from and you just do that somehow kind of one. It was like we had
these meetings, like regular meetings, so we can communicate and find issues earlier and fix them.
Now we are in the point when the game design process is over and the game is going to be produced, and we hope to present this game in this autumn, in October. And yesterday also we had very important meeting with all the partners, and we picked a name for even the name for our game. So it's going to be Draugoteka. So all the who are watching now this our conversation, we invite to follow, of course, follow Bitter channel, and it will be announced when the game will be launched. But if you in the autumn someday would type in Google search window Draugoteka, you will find this game already there. So okay, I suppose we are going to the end of our conversation. So I would ask you maybe just to encourage our youth, young people to play this game. So what would be your encouragements for our people just to try to play this game?
Yeah, I think it would be a really interesting experience. I think you would meet some really, really cool character. Hopefully the players really connect to. And also hopefully they find some really cool books that they would really love afterwards.
Yeah, that's true.
Mm-hmm. And also hopefully maybe you find yourself relating to some of the characters, and you can find, as you said, some good books that could help you figure out some of yourself.
And Thomas, what would your encouragement be? Just short.
Yes, a lot of the same as I said. Also, if you already are a reader, maybe you'll find some new books that you didn't know of. We've tried to be a bit diverse with the cast of characters. So we have 5 very different characters who like different types of books. So even if you're like really into fantasy, for example, you might find some of the other characters interesting as well, because they're talking about books that you might not have been interested in before.
Mm-hmm.
So we've tried to be diverse, so there's a wide array of interests.
And I could say, just to add, that when we saw the scenario of this game, we were so happy, because you are quite young people and you understand the target you create for. And I won't say now the scenario, but we will do it very soon. Just we will present the game already night. And also I will end with this thought, probably just I've heard from our partners in previous conversations that the games are really now becoming not only for entertainment, but games can be very, very serious tool to solve some psychological and even friendship problems, and they can be very real or very serious occupation for our children. So we are trying to create such a tool for our children. So thank you everyone who watched this interview. Thank you our partners, Thomas, Lynn and Benedicte from Black Book, from Game Design Studio in Oslo. Thank you.
Thank you so much.